Here we go again for another free video for the free Active Directory course. In this video, I will look at promoting Windows Server 2008 Core to a domain controller. Windows Server 2008, besides the different editions like Standard and Enterprise, comes in the Full and Core editions. Server Core is a scaled-down version of Windows Server. It has a lot of the same features as the Full Edition, however the major difference is it has a limited GUI. To perform administration on the server, you need to do it from the command prompt. Server Core does support remote desktop, however, when connected to Server Core by remote desktop, you will still get a command prompt. Server Core does support remote administrator tools. If you, for example, installed DHCP on a Server Core computer, you could administer DHCP remotely using the DHCP admin tool. Another advantage of Server Core is that it has a smaller attack surface. The attack surface is the software or hardware that a hacker could use to hack into the server. Since the GUI is limited, there is less software running on the server. Less software also means less updates needed to install on the server. Less software also means less resources running, like memory and CPU. On a busy network, you may want to consider installing a domain controller on Server Core to try and get more performance. You may also use Server Core if you are worried about security. The problem with promoting a server to a domain controller on Server Core is that the limited GUI can't display the wizard for DC promo. To get around this, you can use an answer file or specify the options in the command line. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 computer to demonstrate how to promote a server to a domain controller that is running Server Core. This is a fresh install of Windows Server 2008 Enterprise Core. Nothing has been configured. If I run the command echo percentage computer name percentage, I will get the computer name. This is currently set to the random name that Windows assigns the server when it is first installed. To change this, run the command net dom rename computer. The net dom command can be run from this computer or a remote computer. For this reason, you need to enter in the computer name. Rather than type in the random string of characters that Microsoft set to the computer name, I will enter in localhost. Next, I need to add slash new name colon and the name of the server, which in this case will be DC2. The computer name is now changed and the server needs to be restarted. I will make a few other changes before restarting it. It is recommended that you always complete a name change by restarting the server before promoting a server to a domain controller. In order for this server to contact another domain controller to replicate the Active Directory database, I need to configure an IP address. First, I will run the command netsh interface ipv4 show interfaces. Each interface has a name. The default for the first network connection is local area connection. Rather than typing in a long interface name like this, I will look at the left-hand side and get the index number for that connection and use that in future commands. In this case, local area connection has an index number of 21. The next command that I will run is netsh interface ip4 set address. This will set the IP version 4 address for the network adapter. Next, I need to enter in name equals 21 for the adapter, or I could have also put in local area connection. Following this, I need to add source equals static. If I wanted to use DHCP, I could have put in source equals DHCP. Remember that for a domain controller, you need at least one static IP address. After this, I finally get to put in the IP address, subnet mask, and the gateway with the arguments address, mask, and gateway. Next, I will set an IP version 6 address. The command starts out much the same, netsh interface ipv6 set address. After this, the name parameter changes to interface equals 21. Next, I need to enter in address equals and the IP version 6 address. Now that I have an IP address on the network adapter, I next need to configure the DNS servers. This is once again done with NetSH interface IPv4 followed by add DNS server to tell NetSH I'm configuring a DNS server. After this, once again, I need to put name equals 21 for my network adapter and then address equals and the IP address of my first DNS server. In this case, I will put the IP address of my first domain controller, DC1. It is important to set a DNS server that holds DNS records for that domain, otherwise the promotion to a domain controller will fail. Windows can have multiple DNS servers, so next you need to set which DNS entry that you want to change. In this case, I will set the first one with index equals 1. Since I will be installing DNS on this server as well, I will recall the last command by pressing up and changing the address to the loopback connection, 127.0.0.1. I will also add index equals 2 to the end to change the second DNS server entry. Notice that when I run this command, I get an error message saying that the DNS server is incorrect or does not exist. What has happened is that Windows has attempted to contact the DNS server and has not got a response. This is to be expected because I have not installed DNS as yet. The second DNS server will still get added regardless, so it is safe to ignore this message. If I want to see which roles are already installed on this server, I can run the command oclist. I still add the pipe more switch, so that output will stop once the screen is full. I could install the DNS role when I promote the server, but sometimes it is easier to install the role separately. When you use the GUI interface, it is easy to tick the correct tick box to install the DNS role. When you use the command line or an answer file, it is easy to overlook this, as you will see. Notice the role is listed as DNS Server Core Role. It is important to take note of correct spelling, uppercase and lowercase letters, and the use of hyphens, or the next command will not work. To install the DNS role, run the command start with the W switch. The start command will run another command, and the W switch will ensure the Windows waits until the install is complete. Without the W switch, Windows would return back to the command line without any delay, and you would not know when the install is complete. After the W switch, enter the command that you want to run, in this case, oc setup and the DNS role. Make sure that you use the correct spelling, including correct case and hyphens. The DNS install does take a few minutes to complete, so I have sped up the process. You won't be given any messages telling you the install was successful, but you know it has completed due to the fact you have been given back control of the command line. Before I promote the server to a domain controller, I need to reboot it so the name change I did before will take effect. I can now do this from the command /r/t0. This tells Windows to reboot the server and wait for 0 seconds before doing so. Once the server has rebooted, I will run the command ipconfig /all pipe more to check the changes. At the top, you can see that the host or computer name has changed to DC2. Down further, you can see that network configuration, like IP addresses and DNS server, have also changed. There are two ways you can promote a server to a domain controller: using an answer file or using the command line. First, I will look at using an answer file. To do this, I will map a drive to my other domain controller. In the previous video, I exported the DC promo settings to a text file. This text file I will copy to this computer. Once copied, I will open the file in Notepad, one of the few GUI-based software that works on Server Core. This file was created based on being the first domain controller in the forest. Since I am installing an additional domain controller in the same domain, some changes need to be made to the file before I can use it. If I were to use this file, the install would fail. If you would like a full list of options for this file, please look up Microsoft KB article 947034. First of all, I need to change the top setting replica or new domain. Currently, this is set to domain. Since this is another domain controller in the same domain, I need to change this to replica. Replica simply means another copy of an existing domain controller. The next option below this is new domain. Since this is not a new domain, I will comment this line out by putting a semicolon at the start of the line. Below this is the option new domain name. This needs to be changed to replica domain DNS name since we are adding a domain controller to an existing domain. Next, I need to add the domain, username, and password for an account that has access to add domain controllers to that domain. This account will need to be a member of the domain administrators group. For new domains, it will need to be a member of the enterprise administrators group. The user account is added with the user domain, username, and password options. The last option that I need to set is the safe mode admin password. This is used to recover Active Directory and boot Active Directory into recovery mode. One point I will make with passwords is Windows will edit this file after you use it and remove all the passwords. This is done so if the file falls into the wrong hands after you use it, they won't have what passwords you used. Once I exit and save the file, I can now run DC promo with the slash unattended switch followed by colon and the file name for the answer file. If I were to now press enter, this server would be promoted to a domain controller using the answer file to answer any setup questions. Creating an answer file will allow you to promote a server core computer to a domain controller. But let's face it, creating an answer file can be a lot of work, especially if you had to create it from scratch. One point I will make is that all the options I used in the answer file can be added to the command line so you don't have to make an answer file at all. To demonstrate this, I will use all the options in the answer file as command line switches. First, I will add slash replica or new domain colon replica. This tells DC Promo that this additional domain controller is in an existing domain. Like the text file, I will add slash replica domain DNS name colon and the domain name itfreetraining.local. The next switch I will add is slash confirm GC colon yes. I did not change this in the text file as it was already present. What this does is make the domain controller a global catalog server. I will cover global catalog servers in the next video, so don't worry if you don't understand how they work quite yet. Next, I will add the switches for user domain, username, and password with a user that has permissions to add domain controllers to the domain. Lastly, I need to add the Active Directory recovery password. Once I press enter, the server will be promoted to a domain controller. Like the GUI version, Windows will check to see if the binaries are installed. If not, it will install them for you. The process does take a few minutes, but once complete, the server will connect to another domain controller and start replicating the Active Directory database. The process takes about 5 to 10 minutes to complete, so I will fast forward the video to the end. Once complete, the server will reboot. When the server returns from reboot, it will now be a domain controller. Notice also that the server was automatically added to the IT Free Training domain. If the server was already part of the domain, it could be promoted as well. Windows will simply add it to the domain if it needs to be. We hope you've enjoyed this video on promoting a server core computer to a domain controller. In the next video, I will look at the global catalog server in more detail. The Global Catalog Server works as an index in Active Directory. Once again, thanks for watching.